are Cristina.
And Andrés.
And together, we are Uno, Dos, Tres, Andrés.
And we love exploring the Americas.
We're inviting you to travel with us. But before we head out, we need a map. I hear an instrument. I hear a stringed instrument, almost like the guitar, but not quite.
Oh, ya sé. I know who it is. It's our friend Leandro from Argentina. Hey, Leandro, ¿cómo estás?
Hola, ¿cómo andan?
Bien. Cuéntanos de tu instrumento.
Estoy con un charango, un instrumento autóctono de la zona del altiplano argentino, boliviano, peruano.
You have a map. Can you show us on the map?
Leandro showed us on a map that the charango comes from the altiplano in South America. The altiplano includes parts of Peru, Bolivia, Chile, and northern Argentina. The word altiplano is a compound word made of two words in Spanish. Alto means tall or high. Plano means flat. The altiplano is a high elevation plateau. It's part of the Andes mountain range, and it's where the Andes are the widest. It is one of the largest areas of high plateau in the world. Leandro was just telling us that charango was traditionally made with the body of an armadillo, or quirquincho, as they're called in this part of the world. But now, they're made out of wood.
Por lo general tienen 10 cuerdas, pero también hay algunos que tienen 12 cuerdas. También está el ronroco, que es muy parecido, pero es un poquito más grande y cambia la afinación.
The charango typically has 10 strings, although some variations have 12 strings. The charango has a cousin, the ronroco, which is similar but larger, and it has a deeper sound. Now it was time to hear the huayno, a kind of music that's typical of the altiplano region and played with the charango.
Es el huayno, y el huayno sería...
played on the charango is a traditional song. Have you also composed songs for the charango?
Sí, claro, tengo bastantes canciones.
Leandro, that's a beautiful song. Thank you for sharing. Now, I see that your right hand, you have to move it really fast. Can you show us how fast do you have to move it?
The charango is known for this fluttery sound. It has 10 strings, 5 sets of 2 strings each. So it has a lot of sound to make. A guitar, on the other hand, only has 6 strings.
Tener las cuerdas chiquitas y hacer dobles, porque son 5 pares de 2 cuerdas, es más fácil también hacerlo.
Leandro, so that was the charango, but what other instruments do you have that you use to play the huayno and the rhythms from northern Argentina?
Les puedo mostrar el bombo legüero, que lo tengo aquí.
Leandro was going to show us the bombo legüero. This drum is traditionally made from wood and the skin of a cow, sheep, or goat. Leandro explained that the sound of this drum is so loud and deep that it can be heard a long distance away. That's where it got its name. People used to use this drum to communicate between towns, a una legua de distancia, a league away.
Este instrumento es más del Santiago del Estero, que es una provincia, permiso, del centro de Argentina, centro norte.
Leandro was going to play one of the rhythms that the bombo legüero is used for most, the chacarera.
Es un ritmo muy alegre, rápido. Y se acompaña con guitarras y el bombo legüero es fundamental. Chacarera.
We wanted to learn to play the chacarera too. The first thing we needed to know is that you hit the drum on the parche, the skin of the drum.
¿Sí? Que es lo grave, lo gordo.
And also on the aro, the wooden hoop or frame.
Acá se le enseña como el papito papá, mamita mamá, ¿sí? Entonces, papito papá, se le pega en el parche y en el aro. Papito papá, mamita mamá, salchicha con pan, salchicha con pan. Empezamos en el parche. Papito papá, mamita mamá.
A lot of times people use phrases to teach a rhythm of percussion because it's easier to remember how the pattern goes if you have a phrase to remember it with. The chacarera rhythm is taught with papito papá, mamita mamá. You can also say salchicha con pan, salchicha con pan. That means sausage and bread. So they're easy to remember phrases to help you remember the pattern. Let's see if we can drum out the chacarera. The first thing you need is a drum and some drumsticks. I'm using some pencils and a cardboard box. My cardboard box works because it makes two different sounds, one in the center and one on the rim. Now go find something you can use as a drum and some drumsticks and come back. All right, we're ready to try. Papito papá, mamita mamá, papito papá. Mamita mamá. With one hand, you're hitting the center of your drum that makes the deep sound. And with the other hand, you're hitting the rim of your drum that makes the more high pitch sound. We're going to use the phrase in English, in, out, out, in, out. In, out, out, in, out. That will help us remember how the pattern goes. In, out, out, in, out. In, out, out, in, out. Once we get good at it, we can get even faster. Papito papá, mamita mamá. Try the chacarera challenge.
Y se le da velocidad.
Chacarera. Now, Leandro, you're so talented. You play charango, you play bombo. Do you play any other instrument?
Sí, les puedo mostrar otro instrumento. Permiso.
Ah, otro instrumento.
Sikus.
Sikus.
The sikus also comes from the altiplano. It's made from hollow reeds, and the ends of the reeds are sealed up with wood or cork.
I have a baby sikus.
Baby.
A ver. It's difficult.
Sí, el soplido.
Think about a piano. Why does it have so many keys? Each piano key is only able to make one specific note. That's why there are so many keys, to be able to make all of the notes a musician might want. Well, the sikus is similar. Each reed is only able to make a single note, depending on how long the reed is. That's why the sikus has so many reeds.
Leandro showed us that the reeds on the sikus are covered on one end, so you're not blowing air down the pipe. Instead, you're blowing air across. You can make your own sikus at home if you can find some caps of some markers or pens.
Vayan y busquen una tapita de un marcador y fíjense cómo se puede hacer también un sikus.
This is what you need. Caps that are small and thin and they don't have a hole on this side. This one isn't going to work because it has holes in it. This one will because it doesn't have a hole at the bottom, only a hole right here. Go look for some and come back. I found 3 marker caps that I'm going to use as a sikus. You have to blow really hard across the cap. I got some sound. Now I'm going to tape my 3 caps together to make a sikus. Here it is, I'm ready to try it. All 3 of my caps sound about the same because they're about the same size. But if you look at a sikus, you'll notice that the reeds are different lengths. The longer they are, the lower pitched the sound. You also see that the reeds are perfectly lined up, nice and even, so that when you put your mouth up to them, you can make a good sound. When you're done, don't forget to put the caps back on the marker so they don't dry out.
Look, Leandro, I found a marker and this is going to be my sikus.
Okay.
Leandro, are you ready for the Estrellita challenge?
Okay.
Okay. Can you play Twinkle Twinkle Little Star in some of the rhythms that you were showing us from Argentina?
Estrellita, ¿dónde estás? Quiero verte titilar en el cielo. Estrellita, ¿dónde estás? Quiero verte titilar. En Huayno, pero ahora en el charango. Estrellita, ¿dónde estás? Quiero verte titilar. En el cielo o en el mar, un diamante de verdad. Estrellita, ¿dónde estás? Quiero verte titilar.
Can you do it in rhythm of chacarera? Papito mamá, papito mamá, papito mamá, mamita mamá.
Estrellita, ¿dónde estás? Quiero verte titilar. En el cielo o en el mar, un diamante de verdad. Estrellita, ¿dónde estás? Quiero verte titilar.
Very good, very good. You know, most rhythms that we hear can be divided in units of 2 and 3. And in the chacarera, I hear a mix of 2 and 3. Hay una mezcla de 3 contra 2, de 3 y 2 al tiempo.
Sí, claro.
In the chacarera, you have 2 rhythms happening at the same time. You have a 1, 2, and a 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Let's see if we can keep our rhythm straight. For this challenge, you need a friend. Go get somebody and come on over. First, let's try keeping the 1, 2 rhythm. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Easy enough. Let's try the 3 rhythm now.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Here's the challenge. One person keeps the 1-2 rhythm while the other person keeps the 1-2-3 rhythm at the same time without getting mixed up. 1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-1-2-3-